Hi students, today we are going to see the balance of what we had seen in the previous class. That is subject verb agreement part 2. Part 1 we had seen in the last class. Now we are going to the second part. Here we are going to see certain special subjects. When they come as part of the subject, what happens to the verb is what we are going to see. Suppose as well as and with, they form part of your subject. A sentence you are making like this: the minister with his officers, sorry I made a mistake, the minister with his officers went away. Now here, if as well as or with, as you see here, forms part of your subject, this is the subject of the sentence, the verb will be according to the first subject, that is minister, third person singular. Okay, that is what is the first one. When the words as well as or with forms part of your subject, then you have the verb according to the first noun or pronoun that comes. Next one, suppose you have not only but also, either or, neither nor. Suppose they become part of your subject, the sentence that you are going to write, its subject, if they are part of it, then the verb will be according to the second subject. Look here, either you or your friends. Here it is plural, so you have what? Have done. So when you use either or, neither nor, not only but also as part of your subject, the verb will be according to the second noun or pronoun used in that subject. Next one. One of the, everyone, either, neither, each. Suppose any of these words forms part of your subject, that is either, neither, each, one of the, everyone. Suppose these forms part of your subject, you have to use a singular verb. Everyone in the class is happy. Suppose there are 60 students in the class. When we use everyone, we are referring to all the students, but one by one, each after each, that's what is the meaning of it. So you have a singular verb. You cannot use everyone in the class are happy, since we are referring everyone in the class. No, it is one by one, one after the other. So we use a singular verb. Another one is none. When none is part of your subject, if it is referring to quantity, then you can use a singular verb. If it is used in other situations, countable nouns and all, you can use any verb. That is a singular verb or a plural verb. For example, none of his films, this is plural noun here, have been awarded or has been awarded. Only none has this particular quality of using both the verbs. Okay, you can use when none becomes part of a subject and the subject is singular or plural. Here it is plural. You can use have or has, that is plural or singular verb as part of it. These are some of the situations where we use. Now again, if you think much, little, more, when we use that, again we have to use a singular verb. Many a, if you use this, or this becomes part of your subject. Many, we know plural. Many, many students have passed. passed in the examination. That is plural. But many a student is careless in the class. Many a is referring to one. So we use many a as singular verb. These are the important points that we should note when we think about or talk about subject verb agreement, or if these words become part of your subject, the verbs accordingly is to be used. Yesterday I have sent you the materials. You would have gone through that. Now listen to these and do the exercises, please. Thank you.